4 a.m., maybe closer to 5 a.m., called me in early for this. Oof. I don't know if you can see that, but that is a box truck that's a tangled mess in between the two freeways on the 210 around Allen, and it's on the train tracks. So they're going to wait for, I believe it was MTA or whatever, to give us the green light before they secure everything and we start working on it. It's going to be a gnarly one because, it's fully loaded. I think it's Amazon packages. And if you can tell, that thing is just completely tangled. Looks like I don't know which way is the front or back, but the axle came off. Chassis destroyed and the box is mega tweaked, so we're going to have some fun. Oh, and it's raining, because why wouldn't it be? It's been 113 degrees for I don't know how long, and then freak rain out of nowhere, which is much appreciated. Thank you, Mother Nature. Once they give us that hard closure, we can position the trucks. See, that's the rear right there. And as you can see, that chassis messed up, man. Thing's pretty bad. The other side is the 210 westbound, and in the middle is the MTA train tracks. I got Hulk right here looking nice. And Big Flipper. We're gonna need a Landoll, because that thing's not towable. And probably one of my box trucks to put the load in. Cool. They gave us the brake we needed. They wanted me to do a turnaround. Figured this would be the best bet. We're gonna lift this thing up once empty and rotate it in between our trucks. Kind of like that set of doubles we did. I posted a few weeks ago. And then the Landoll's gonna park here and boom. We put it right on there. Yeah, that box is destroyed. Came off the chassis. There's many calls that just because we have big trucks and the right equipment, we can upright and move things fully loaded without an issue. There's some cases like this one you just have to offload. There's no salvaging this. It's completely broken off the back. The roof's gone. Everything's compromised. So as soon as we start lifting up, the load stays on the floor and everything else comes up. That's pretty bad. So we're gonna have to do some weird rigging. I guess lift up a portion of the back so we can safely remove all the load. Alright, I gotta cut the roof while Dave is gonna suspend the back. So let me start that with my Milwaukee cutoff saw. Alright, now that I cut the roof open, it's gonna make it a lot easier to offload. So when my box truck gets here, it's gonna park in between the two rotators. Right there. David and I are gonna start off. It's not too bad. A lot of big packages, but these things are known to be overloaded. This one doesn't seem too bad. Shouldn't take us too long to empty this out. And then once empty, we can, I guess, attempt to rig to this. It's gonna be a very awkward flip because there's no structure. But if anyone can do it, it's Dave and I. Well, we're doing pretty great timing. This thing wasn't too loaded, so we got my box truck not even halfway full. Now it's just the little packages. We can flip it like that. The reason we want to empty it out now is because it's on its side. It's easy to access. You can see right there. I mean, the whole thing's done. So emptying it, transporting it fully loaded would be stupid since all the packages will come out. So you empty it now. And I might need two Landolls. Like Dave said, the straps from the frame to the box came undone. What that means is the chassis, this portion right here, is attached to the box with these. All up and down, and they're all broken up in the front and the top. There's only like three of them holding it in place. So we'll have to cut them and put the chassis and cab on one Landoll and the box on another. This thing is mega tweaked. All right, MacGyver's gonna be taking off the battery. It started to spark right now. So once he does that, I'm gonna be cutting these straps. I did one really quick right here. Cut really nice and easy. I do that up there, and then two on the back, and this thing is ours. I love this Milwaukee equipment. All straps are now cut. Now MacGyver is just gonna finish up with the remaining wires, and the chassis and box are completely separated. No, they took off the power. You guys need to see how tangled this mess is, man. Yeah, it's ready. All right. See, the transmission and the oil pan are completely busted and the transmission is hanging, so we're gonna have to chain that up. Like, it broke right there at the casing. We found the axle. It's all the way over there on the other side of the freeway. You can't see it, but I'll put a red circle How I got that far, I have no idea. Unit number 4, one of our newest and best trucks, tandem axle flatbed. It's a bad unit right there, man. All the way, Raymond. let me know when to go down. Going down. Up, going up. Going down. On my end.
You got a lot of room this way.
Yeah?
All right.
So let me just scoot it up, go in and up. Yeah. You know how to help me, Dave? Let me go up and you go down with your boom, it'll push it. See? Now we're good, right? Solid? All right, good work, guys. I got no tension. Just like that, it's done. We've made sure to put a lot of cribbing in the front because the transmission, engine broken, leaf spring, the steering rod, all that stuff would do some horrible damage to the bed. So you just spend a couple minutes cribbing it right. It protects the bed and makes it safer for transport. Now we get this out of the way, then we bring up the box and put that on the Landoll. Good job, Raymond. We did a good 4-point securement. So this is ready to go to the shop.
Okay.
We'll get a 180 for it first. Next is the box truck. The actual box, I should say, there's no truck. All right. Well, I talked to the owner right now. He just showed up. Oops, paperwork on the floor. We're gonna take the load. He's got a box truck too. We're just gonna get off the freeway with the box truck and they're gonna offload him. Get that clear off the freeway while we tackle this. We use the rotator to put the gas tank in the front axle. Same thing with the hood and part of the box. And then it should be papitas, as we say. Flip that, pick it up. It's gonna be hard because of those stupid lines. So I'll probably drag it as close to the K-rail as possible and then flip it over. Sweet. We got MacGyver in the box truck ready to go. We're gonna get up the next exit and do the offload. The flatbed's unloading all the parts. Now the final piece of the puzzle is using the rotators to put the box on the Landoll. That should be the easy part. That thing's empty. It's jacked up. It might be a bit hard to flip, especially because the walls are compromised. The chains might go through, but like we said, it's empty. It doesn't have to be perfect, so whatevs. Enrique, great angle. He's just gonna get it super close to the wall, and then Dave's gonna back up to the right of his passenger side on the cab.
Please first.
been in overtime mode, putting the trucks away super quick. We got it loaded. A lot of, as I always say, Frankenstein stuff here. We had to put it a bit offset, and let me show you what we did to the front. I didn't want it transported sideways. I needed upright because it would stick out too much. It still sticks out this way, but a lot less. So what I did is we threw in the straps to keep the walls from coming open, padding it as much as we can, set it on wood, and then let this hang. Then we got the rotators that we are going to be following behind them all the way back to the shop. That's a really fun job. A lot of labor, a lot of cleaning up. Well, our job here is done, guys. All that's left is just for MTA, Caltrans, and whoever else is in charge of the tracks to fix them or inspect them. A lot of people are going to be late to work today, and man, I feel bad for all those people. I hope you guys enjoy this fun little job. We're out of here, man. Peace.